Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today I'm going to show you a very quick look at Kagi, which is a search engine that I've actually been really enjoying over the past few months. I have tried alternate search engines to Google, and I always go back to Google because it's just more reliable for me, but Kagi's stuck in a way that other search engines haven't, and I'm going to show you very quickly today. One, because you don't need to see a ton, hopefully this will give you a good idea really quickly, and two, I'm losing my voice, so I don't have much time to record this video, but I wanted to get it out there anyway. So let's start with thing number one, which are ads. So on Google, let's do a search for best iPhone 15 Pro cases. You're going to get ads. You're going to get a lot of sponsored content that aren't necessarily what you want. Sometimes they're helpful, but more often than not, they're not really what you're looking for. And then there's some more results down here. And, you know, I think there are some good things with how Google displays its results and lets you filter down. But ads are annoying. Sponsored posts are annoying. On Kagi, you're paying for the service, so there are no ads. It just kind of lets you see the search results. It has sections for discussions, which I really dig. It does have posts here. It does have some sections for news. Some listicles are all bundled together, images. Like, I just find the searches really helpful. And also, if it's a really recent post, the date is kind of highlighted here in blue, so you can see like this is a fresh result. Another thing I really like is that you can basically promote and demote URLs or domains from your search results. So here's a Wall Street Journal article, and I have nothing against the Wall Street Journal necessarily, but I don't subscribe to them, and that means often I click these links and I can't actually see the page. So if I hover over this icon here, you're going to see some info on basically this domain. And so I can adjust the ranking for myself. I can totally block it. I can raise it. I can pin it to the top, so it's basically in every single search that I do. I'm gonna lower this one because I don't want them to be totally gone, especially if I'm looking for something that happens to be a Wall Street Journal article, but I can lower it in the rankings, and that's going to just make it so I don't see these as high in the results unless I keep scrolling. They also give you some other information down here, but yeah, so let's go ahead and do that. And then New York Times, I do subscribe to the Times, so let me raise that. So a New York Times article is higher ranked in my search results. So the next time I search for something, New York Times will be higher, Wall Street Journal will be lower. This is sounding like a political statement. That's not what it's meant to be, but yeah, take it for what you will. If there's a URL that you hate seeing in search results, you can get it out of there. If there's one that you love and want to see at the top all the time, if there are results, pin it or just rank it higher. Another cool feature is called Lenses, and that lets you do a search and kind of filter it by the sort of context you're looking for. So, for example, I just did a programming-related question, how to center an image in a div, CSS, and it gives me some good search results and everything, and it gives me a kind of a quick answer over here. I can also enable a lens, right? And so there's a couple here that are pre-programmed. One of them is called programming, and this is gonna prioritize, obviously, Stack Overflow and any other site that kind of has programmery stuff. If you're searching for news, you can set it to world news, academic searches like that, and then you can edit these and do your own. One that I really think is cool is called Small Web. And what Small Web does is it has a list of kind of smaller websites that it has that it says are kind of non-commercial domains and topics. And so if you enable this one, you can select Small Web, and now it's going to favor smaller websites. So Stack Overflow is gone, but websites that are a little smaller. I mean, Smashing Magazine isn't small by any means, but yeah, it lets you see kind of results from littler sites, which I think can be really interesting. Another cool thing is if you're looking for an old link, for example, I'm looking up iPhone 4 reviews, which are from like 12 years ago. A lot of these websites are still up, but some of them aren't, but they still show up in search results. And a cool thing you can do is click these three dots here, and you can open the result on the web archive, which is just really, really nice to be able to find these old links. If they're dead now, you can actually go back and see them. And so we can actually go back to like 2011 and see the version of the site that was up when this actually posted. This is a little thing and it's not always useful. And again, the CSS on the web archive can sometimes be a little janky, not quite 100% perfect, but it is really cool to have a quick way to do this. Another really rad thing are keyboard shortcuts. So after I've done the search, I don't have to just scroll with my mouse and kind of click the links. I can just use the down arrows to kind of go through the links. And okay, here's the iMore review. Let me just hit enter and I go to it. Hit a keyboard shortcut to go back and I can kind of arrow through them again. There's more keyboard shortcuts. I'll try to put them on screen now. But honestly, just this arrowing up and down, I find really useful. If you want to open in a new tab, it's Command Enter. That's going to open in a new tab down here. And yeah, just really, really nice to be able to navigate things with the keyboard. I just find that really useful. Another thing that's really cool are Bing shortcuts. So if you want to search a website directly, you could do exclamation point and YT a better computer, and that's going to search for a better computer on YouTube. You can do that with other things. You could do actually G. Let's do iPhone cases, and this is going to do a search on Google. And there's a whole bunch of other ones, but if you want to search for another website or do a direct search on another website, you're able to do that through Kagi, which DuckDuckGo, I think, pioneered, and Kagi's using it as well. Getting to the end here, but another thing I really like, let's do Resident Evil 4 review. Another thing I really like is being able to sort your results. So you get the default kind of prioritization that, of course, you would get from any other search engine, but you can also change the order. So you can change by time. So let's go ahead and see these are the earliest reviews. How do I change the order? Descending. So I can change it to, here's a review from yesterday. Here's ones from like just the last couple days. Or again, if I want to go ascending, I can see the oldest links first, which is really, really cool. But it's not just time. You can also sort just by website, how many ad trackers are on the website. So if you want to see the results with the least number of trackers, there's this medium site, nordic.ign.com apparently. But anyway, there's all these different ways to sort your results, which comes in handy sometimes. And then finally, there's their iOS app, which I think is awesome and the best out there for custom search engines. So for example, if you want to use Brave as your search engine on your desktop, you can just set it as your default in your browser, no problem. But you can't do that on iOS. There's only like 5 that Apple has selected that you can set as your default search engine. Kagi's not one of them. But Kagi does have an app you can download, and the entire point of the app is to be an extension that runs in Safari that will automatically redirect any search you do to Kagi. So from my perspective, every search looks like it's actually just going to Kagi. It doesn't feel like I'm sacrificing by using this different search engine that Apple has approved as a default one. Totally seamless, works great. I use it on my iPhone and iPad, and it just feels like Kagi is my default search engine, and that's awesome. So I really love that. But that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. The pricing for Kagi is, I think there's free for a couple searches. It's $5 a month for up to 300 searches and $10 a month for unlimited. I use the $5 a month plan. It works fine for me. I did run into a limit once, but apparently I usually search for less than 500 or 300 things per month. So that's what I've been using. But again, links to everything in the description. I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.